Did I check the entertainment complex? Yeah, I did. Industrial zone, no. Let's go with the holy site. We'll build it there, remove the Kurgan, and we'll be able to upgrade it. Because yes, it only gives me plus one holy right now, but as I add more and more upgrades on it, it should be great. We're playing Civ and having 12-hour sessions. Oh, yeah. Especially on the larger maps. Ugh. This one is actually a standard map. However, the map starts looking smaller and then expands as you explore out. For instance, I looked like I had fully explored everything, but it seems that is not true. Do I want to start getting Amsterdam? Plus 10 gold. Amsterdam's way over there, though. It would be nice to gain some bonuses with them. But it could set it there for food, or it's just tough. Stockholm would give me science, though. I don't have a lot of science points right now. It's not until this is built. We'll continue with what we're doing right now. Continue giving them additional production, because we have one more trader being produced right now, and I can send that to wherever the heck I want. What time is it for you? It is like 3 a.m. Yes, it is 3:09. Yeah, I do have the same time. It is really late, but I also have this lovely drink here that is keeping me going. Yep, glorious mountain time. You little scum! Keep moving! Charge, damn you! There's my settler. He's making good progress. He's about halfway from where he started to his destination. After that, I think I'll build another builder. City-state quest complete. I've completed the quest for Candy City.
That's someone who works for the federal government, but doesn't have to take the civil service examination.
Ha! Interesting. Let me check my policies, because that's a really nice policy. No, I'm still going to keep my plus one production, I think, in all cities, because that's still a nice bonus for speeding up their production, or speeding up their construction, I should say. Fortify. Trader! You trader! Should I send you to Candyland or Stockholm? Let's go Stockholm, I think. Create another road leading up or attaching to that one. And I already have Kabul under my thumb, so it'd be nice to get Stockholm there too. Then again, Amsterdam isn't in a very advantageous position. No, the science is too tempting. The science is too tempting. Let's begin the route. Yeah. Divine right. Two relic slots. Monarchy. Let's go for it. Alright, so for production. Yeah, let's get the market, I think, right now. Meeting house for the holy site. Ooh, plus two production. Ooh. But market. But money. But production. But money. Let's go for the market for now, then production. Then I'll get a worker. So I got 22 turns for that to be completed. It's going to be a while, actually. $260 to purchase a worker. Alright. It's not going to happen anytime soon. Everyone else is focusing on... Holy crap! 33 turns for you. That's actually horrible. Who needs orders? How dare you require my intervention? Damn it, sir! Get your own shit settled. Alright, next turn. That was a quick road to produce. Unless it was already being produced. America has progressed from the medieval age to the Renaissance. I don't think they beat me. I'm pretty sure I'm already in the Renaissance, but I could be wrong. Ooh, that's bad. We have a barbarian encampment somewhere. Where did you come from? They usually sit up right there. Let's see about dealing with that punk. You go ahead and sit up right there. Boston should just be a quick grab. There is no difficulty there whatsoever. Washington, on the other hand, which will be the next target, is going to be a hard nut to crack. But I should be able to build some siege engines eventually here, which will take care of that, no problem. Alright, let's continue. Oh. You need orders. That's good, that's where I wanted you. Defensive position. Next turn. So I don't want him attacking my damn traitor. Which he might, actually. I'm not sure if I can stop him now. I should have kept my unit attached to that one. That's what I really should be doing more often, is guarding my traitors. Speaking of which, I have one more trade capacity. So I think I'll build one over here when I get the chance. Ooh, there's another scout. Oh, there it is. There it is. It's over here. Found it. Come on! Go! Choose production. Oh! You're actually done. Where can you build an aqueduct? Increase housing severely. Get the shrine done first, I think. All right, I like where everything's positioned. Oh, I have been going for a while. 5 hours and 11 minutes so far. Don't you dare! Nice. Major victory. We'll take their place and we'll help to... No, not quite. I thought we would, but we didn't. I'm a little bit scared now because they might take my settler, but I should be able to take it back right away, though. So we should be alright. Oh, shit. They got another encampment right here. Is there any other people I can borrow? Anybody? Anyone? Hello? I should have a crap ton of cavalry. I think they're all over here now. Yes, they are. I don't have as many units as I think I do, is the problem. Do I need to bring you back? I guess. 5 turns. Yeah, sure, I'll drag your ass over there for a second. Luckily, if I kill that, if this guy doesn't finish me off and I kill that unit, then I'll regain the health. I should be able to quickly take their emplacement here, and my archers will hopefully get in a position to assault that thing. I'm just worried that they will weaken it too much that this guy can actually kill them. Like this. Nope, they failed, and I just gained health because of it. Ha! Ha! Screw you. That's what you get, punk. That is what you get. Let me move my archers down here into position. Alright, now I can move you to assist him. So, it's still going to take you more turns, though. Oh, shit, they got cavalry. That's something I didn't want to see. I do have the walls, though, and I can fire. Nice. Go, city, go. I am kicking ass right now, pretty much. I guess I can start with the story again. So I started off right here. I had France up here in lovely Paris. The Aztecs were to my northwest. Spreading around the map, Paris decided to make war with Kabul here. They took the city. I then took advantage of their weakened state, went to war with them, freed Kabul, and turned it back into a city-state, which got rid of my warmongering issues. I then laid siege to Paris, took it over. Somewhere in between that, I got a bunch of free workers and a settler from Paris. Used that to settle a city over here. During this war, I also settled this town from one I created there. I then had a settler pop up here from the Aztecs, which were my northwest. They only had one city. For whatever reason, they sent their settler all the way over here. So I took him because I couldn't resist a free settler. And that settler is now making his way over here. Nearly got taken by those damn bandits there, but luckily we survived. And he's making his way up here to make another city. So I'm pretty much dominating right now. The biggest threat I have left on this continent is the American civ right over here. There is apparently one more civ, so the map does expand as you explore. Apparently England is around. But, yeah, I haven't encountered them yet. Anyway, next turn. Alright. These bandits are going to be a slight nuisance to deal with. EVE Online was blowing up so much hate there. I wouldn't be surprised. Well, are you talking about that guy that wanted to actually sue someone because they, stole something from him?
That is, to dispute what God may do is blasphemy. So it is sedition to dispute what a king may do.
It's like, wasn't one guy so pissed off with a corporation, he put like a $30,000, like literal $30,000 bounty on the entire clan? I think, yes, I was, Brody. I think I remember that, if I'm not mistaken. Let's talk in a stick. In which case, I have no idea. Oh, I had no military policy? What? So I just unlocked one now. Ooh.
Let's not do that. Ooh, bastions I really like.
Let's do bat. No! This is a tough one. I mean, there's like three different cards I'd love to either have. There's the unit maintenance reduction, the amenity for a garrison unit, which I have at least two cities with a garrison unit. City defense strength is going to help if I go to war again. The production bonus for like cavalry would allow me to get my knights. Nah, just internal EVE Online. Corp stuff is funny, brutal. Oh yeah, that is definitely an RP centric insanity. And they are going free to play too, which I was semi tempted towards, but I don't know. I'm the kind of EVE player that is perfectly satisfied sitting on a belt all day long and just watching it disappear. That was my thing. I lived to be a miner. Unfortunately, the corporation I was with kind of all decided to go to a certain area with leaving me behind, and Corp went to war with us and ended up destroying my face. It was like a small corp of one or two people, but they fucking... I couldn't even put a dent in the guy. And just obliterated me. So I was like, fuck it, I'm done. What is the saying for that? It's like, are my eyes bleeding? No. Am I drowning in my own drool? No. Okay, I'm fine then. Let's go with that for now. Well, I'm not really in a... No, we'll go with this. We'll go with that, I think. That was a tough one. That was a tough one. Let's retreat. You keep going. You move forward one and bombard that prick. Yeah, Silver Utopia is kicking ass right now. Oh yes, I should probably finish this punk off. Alright. Done. So this one's gonna gain some amenities. That'll be done in a turn. Alright. You go back here and give them some amenities. Let's choose the next civic. I guess we'll go with feudalism, might as well. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. When you quit EVE Online, you win. Not to mention that certain weapon types just seemed more powerful in a way. Like torpedoes with the Galante. They seem to do far, far more damage than my hybrids could even compare to. Paris, what am I gonna... Ooh, shit. Oh, fuck. That's not good. Damn. It's not good at all. Choose a production. I want some horsemen. You continue going up to here. I'll build it right here. So that way I gain quick access to the iron. If I build it there, though, I can make two quick, No. No, I don't think so. Because if I build a Kurgan here, then I would gain at least one two adjacency bonuses. Which I wouldn't get any other way, likely. Alright. If only I had guns and planes right now. Give it time. Give it time. Also, I should have bought another trade route by now. I forgot this is going to give me a negative bonus. Shit, that was a bad idea. That was a bad move, man. Bad move. Oh well. Nothing I can do now. It's done. America has swordsmen. That's going to make things a little more difficult. I am spread out, that is for damn sure. I haven't really... Then again, I've been focusing a lot on civic research and just been using what is left of my military from the wars to fight. So that's why I'm not doing as well right now against these barbarians, because all of my military forces are, well... mildly stagnant by this point, I'll say. Alright. Gain some health back from this punk. Decisive victory. Did 6 hours of Excel before stream even started. Ha! Oh, nice! And my Scythian perk has kicked in once again. Because I have... What the hell do I have again? Basically, anytime I build a horseman or a horse archer, I gain two of them. So my military is about to massively expand again. Increase production, or I could get another two horsemen in two turns. I think I'm going to go for two horsemen in two turns. Okay. I want a builder. Because I need to send a builder up to these guys once they've constructed the city. I'm going to get some quick improvements and buy some tiles here so they can advance their civ really, really quickly. Defend there for a second. Alright. I'm liking how this is going so far. So I'm rebuffing up my military once more. Oh, also I got the lumber mill here in a second. Sweet. Oh! So, this is going to be a tough one. Actually, no, it's not. I'm trying to think of where I could take advantage of that the most. Ah, you damn fool. Oh, they have some horse archers.
I'd imagine the whole world is one big machine. Machines never come with any spare parts, you know. They always come with the exact amount they need.
That's a good one. What's next? Armory, military engineer. pikemen. Doesn't require steel or anything. Strong against mounted units. I could go for the knight. Let's go for the knight. So that I can upgrade my units really easily. Okay, you're going to move down there. You're going to head over here. You are going to apparently do nothing. Upgrade 200 gold? Holy shit! No, fortify. Alright. Toronto, increase production. I can't go to here. Considering I can go all the way to freaking Amsterdam, that surprises me that I can't go over there. But alright. Candyland? Paris. Get it going to Paris. Alright, so, the plan. I'm gonna bombard this punk, kill him, gain some health back. You are going to go rip apart these guys for a major victory. And then we're gonna proceed forward with my current mounted units here. This isn't gonna last too much longer, but I've really gotta be cautious with these barbarian encampments. They made them much stronger than they used to be. So caution is definitely necessary to a point. How are we doing over here? They're on the way. 4 more turns for their worker. We should be good. And by then I'll have a decent amount of money as well. I can really buff shit up. And I'm also about to get another 2 horses as well. So we're not quite to the point where we're going to be sieging. But we're getting there. I should probably make sure every single one of my cities has a fortification now. That would definitely be a priority. Oh, American missionary. Don't like that. Why, you cocky little bugger, you.
We have uncovered a way to increase our farming output. To tap into this potential, I suggest we try to maintain 2 adjacent farms to each plot of farmland.
Oh. Knowledge of stirrups has advanced considerably. Sweet! That's exactly what I'm learning right now.
With the advance of feudalism came the growth of iron armor, until, at last, a fighting man resembled an armadillo.
Let's take a look here. I want to change my government, because I did unlock monarchy. And there's no reason why I shouldn't go for monarchy. Medieval walls. Yes. Confirmed. Excellent. Excellent. Increase city defense and reduce maintenance cost. Done. Confirmed. Beautiful. Let's do it. Okay. Let's see. So, the plan of action here is to have you assault and destroy them. You're going to move forward one and bombard these punks. That's going to get his health back up. This is going to hopefully get his health back up. And then we finish off the last bugger. Yep, GG. With the barbarians being a lot stronger now at this point, I kind of wish I was getting more for killing them. Or for not killing them, but for capturing their camps. Still got 11 turns until that's done. Alright, choose a new civic. Guild. Let's definitely go for that one. Choose production. Let's get that meeting home produced, or meeting house, whatever the hell it's called. Brrr, 6 more turns till the wonder is completed. Where's actually the wonder? Nice, looking good. I won't even need you. Armadillo, wait, what? Turtle would be more applicable? What, applicable? Something? There were actual Roman formations named for different kinds of turtle actions. Oh, yeah! Don't ask me to name any off, but yeah. That was a mild annoyance. There we go. And now I'll have you just finish them off. Done! Peace out, punk. Oh, did he live? I'll be damned. Well, then let's deal with that problem, shall we? Alright, now with this massive increase in my military force, we can begin planning the assault of America. Now, for the assault of America, I'm going to start needing to produce some siege weapons, so all of my military forces from now on are going to be siege-based. Okay, I don't have any archers left other than the one, which is currently doing other things. I am going to take my horsemen, however, and I'm going to fortify all of my cities to start off with, and that way we get a amenities bonus. So you're going there, you're going here, you're going there, and you, my friend, are just going over here to join your brothers. Alright, three more turns to stir up so we can upgrade them to knights. Yep, Murica's next on my agenda. Man, the amount of faith we're producing is excellent. Alright, oh, they made it. And nice, the water available here is good. Found a city. You fortify there. Give it an amenities bonus. You fortify here. You move south. Fortify until healed. Give them a bonus. Everyone else has their orders. Production. Granary. And I'm actually... we'll immediately buy out those. Alright. Once this is done, I'm going to work on a trader. And it's going to move in between these two. Creating roads and boosting overall production. After that, I want to make an aqueduct. Make some boats to look around. I really should. I really, really should. Actually, I think I even have a port here. Or is that just a fishing? No, I think that is actually a port. But I'm not sure if I even own any technology for... well, I do. I think I have one tech for sailing, but it's not something I've been focusing on at all. I might do so after strips. Who needs orders? Defend there. Good enough. Pardon me. Excellent. I could take control of their military, but something tells me in 30 turns I wouldn't be able to get their military where I need them. Okay, good. You're here. Let's send you up to the cattle resource to start off with. Next production, we want a trader. Oh, geez, that's going to take 7 turns. I can produce a gallery, yes. But that's it. Aqueduct will take 16 turns. I really just want to buy that outright. No, it's 320 gold. We'll just produce the trader for now. It's gonna take 7 turns, which sucks a little bit, but it'll be fine. Afterwards, I need another builder to start repairing all this stuff here. Gotta repair all the damage that I inflicted myself. Trying to make them surrender initially. Before I learned, oh wait, I can kill them all. And take over. That's a better idea. That's a better plan. I like that plan.
Crush your enemies. See them driven before you. And hear the lamentations of their vermin. This is the way it is done.
That totally didn't screw up my throat at all. Anyway. One more turn for Strups. Teddy Roosevelt. Let's see how I'm doing in the world rankings. Science, I am in third place. Oh wow, yeah, there's a whole bunch of unmet players still.
Few inventions have been so simple as the stirrup, but few have had so catalytic an influence on history.
So this isn't even remotely over yet. Alright, let's start working on some shipbuilding. Well, we'll get celestial navigation first, then shipbuilding. Ooh, 2 turns, and this one's done. Excellent. Ooh, hello. Shit. Oh, fuck. We got a barbarian encampment up there. I need to send someone. Take him 8 turns, we'll get there. How about you? 8 turns, do it. I know. I'm hoping that forest will slow him down. If it doesn't, my warriors should be able to take him out. No, I didn't say I was going to call it a night when I took the Aztecs. I just said I was going to make peace with the Aztecs initially, and then when I learned that I could take them out, I decided to do that instead. I don't think I've mentioned anything about quitting yet, but yeah, I'm approaching that fairly soon. Well, not fairly soon. I take that back. I got another at least 2-3 hours left in me. Though I am approaching the bottom of this energy drink. So, yeah, that may affect things. Ooh, shit. Let's wake you up, too. Got a barbarian encampment down there that needs slaughtering.
In a dusty, bustling Woo! Corner of the Indian state of Bihar, there is a magical place that one might think of as the hub of Buddhism.
Visitor guide. Very nice. Knowledge of banking has advanced.
You can't go around arresting the Thieves Guild. I mean, we'd be at it all day.
more like all year. I like that commercial hub adjacency bonus. Ooh. Declare holy war. Liberation War, Conquest War, Protectorate War, Diplomatic Service, Mercenaries. 50% discount on all unit upgrades? Yes! I could use that. Something fierce. We have Apostles. Ooh. No. No. I reject all of your opinions. Do it. Launch Inquisition. Spread religion. I use that to spread religion to my city over there. Let's also go convert Toronto. Death Rain. They'll send out them. Or send them out. Cough. Words. I'm starting to lose my mind. Taoism. We must spread the joy of Taoism. Alright, next. I need to reseal off this gap here. Oh yeah, I was gonna build the wall, I think. That never happened.
Set your course by the stars, not by the lights of every passing ship.
Alright. That was a quick one. Alright, let's get shipbuilding now. Excellent. Is there another barbarian camp over here? So help me if there's another barbarian camp. It looks like scouts just turn into barbarians. It's not cool, man. It's not cool. Who needs orders? Oh, yes. If I don't move, I can make two attacks. I forgot about that. Woo! Upgrade is amazing. I love that upgrade. Archer max upgrade is the best. Absolute freaking best. For a defensive battle, you are, if you have a bunch of archers with max level in a defensive position, you are going to obliterate most enemy forces. And if they can keep that when they upgrade to crossbowmen, and beyond that even, I mean, imagine the riflemen taking two attacks as long as they're stationary. Nice, five turns and this will be done. And this will be done in one. Nice. How are we doing down here? 19 still. Dear lord, that's taking a while. Oh well. It'll take as long as it takes. These orders. You're going to Toronto. To spread the good book of Taoism. Oh, looks like America's already here to spread their heathen belief to my Canadian brothers. How dare they? Damn you, America. always interfering with my plans. Now he's going to retreat, but I should be able to take one step forward and F him up regardless of what he does. Nice. Change production! We would get a good adjacency bonus there, one. But it's just one. What else could we do? Ooh, Chitnisa. I know what I'm gonna do. I know exactly what I'm gonna do. First, I'm gonna build the industrial zone. Right here, which will give us a production bonus. I will then build the Chitnisa right next to it. With that additional production bonus in hand. Although, I am a little worried. I am a little worried that I will, you know, someone else will get it before I do at that point, but it should be good. Alright. Spread religion. Must be in my territory. But I'm going to wait until I get the mercenaries one, because then I can upgrade it for cheaper. I can't believe you didn't move, you damn fool. And you guys, go ahead and build that pasture. I'm gonna send you out to explore, because I'm a little worried about them. I think there's another barbarian encampment somewhere up here where I haven't seen it yet. Good morning! How's it going? Welcome back, I should say. So I believe you were here earlier, if I'm not mistaken. Four more turns. Don't do it! Don't do it! Ah, you bastard. I knew you were gonna do that. Something's happening. We need more housing over here, eh? One more turn and we can have more housing. Oh, shit! Culture and two food. Yes, we will build the Kurgan right here. Unless, actually, I have a better idea. Spread religion. Aha! I've converted my Canadian brothers to Taoism. Fantastic. My job here is done. Plus one envoy. Woohoo! Welcome, Drop Zone. Alright, one more turn and I will have that. Then I can start building an aqueduct, which will give them the housing that they require. In four turns, I'll have the shipbuilding, and after the aqueduct, I can build my first ship and get that to work. Uh-oh. They actually attacked me? That's hilarious. That's hilarious. The amount of damage they're doing to themselves, the moment I attack them, they're done. They are done. I can actually send them to Toronto, but no. I want to send them here. Confirmed. will rebuild the road and boost their production. Yeah, the moment I attack them, they're going to die and my health is going to be restored. It's like, thank you for giving me additional experience. That's funny. That's just silly of them. It's like, you might as well bend over for me, lad. Alright. We want to chuck that baby right there. Aqueduct on the way. Alright, this is going to use him up, so we won't need to keep you defending there anymore. Let's get you over here and give him the amenities he needs. Oh, I found a barbarian encampment. Now, if they attack us here, we might actually take some damage. Oh, shit, someone converted us to Judaism. Or maybe they were already Judaism. That might have actually been the Aztecs' initial faith. So, yeah. I'll have to reconvert them at some point. Right now, though, my focus is on here. Spread religion. Alright. That was easy. Alright, let's see if I can send them up here then, and we will reconvert them. Or should I use them up? You know what? I'm going to use you guys in our lovely town of Cabal. I might as well get our allies upgraded while we're at it. So I found one of the barbarian camps. There's also one up here, too. But these guys are now approaching to take care of that one. So this should be wiping out all the barbarians that are currently causing us issues. Cough. As long as they... Well, they might attack me. Yeah, I figure they would. They have the advantage right now. But I get to attack them twice, so...
One is despoiled by mercenaries.
Yes, 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 yes.
By one's enemies.
Change policy. I love this policy. Where is it? Where is it? 50% discount on all unit upgrades. Done. We'll swap it out with that one. Professional army. Fan-freaking-tastic. Ooh, newly trained builders gain 2 extra build actions. That is really tempting. Doesn't quite double the effectiveness, but still pretty good. International trade routes, though. No. No, that's good enough. Confirm policies. Well, time to get wrecked, son. Time to get wrecked. Nice doing business with you, foo. Fortify, give some amenities. You guys are pretty much almost here. Oh, shit. That wasn't quite expected. That's going to be bad, though, because they're going to attack and probably wipe us out. Oh, well. Theocracy government. War of religion. I'm going to go with that. Sounds like a really nice policy. Ooh, claim a great person. Gain 200 gold. Gain 1 envoy. Heck yeah.
A great merchant has come to our civilization. Each one has a unique talent, which will help our economy
Indeed. Mercantilism has advanced considerably. Let's send an envoy to... Oh wow, Toronto's at 7. Kabul. That way... We almost have them maxed out. Or should I bother? What do I gain for you guys? Can we discover a new natural wonder? That's not going to happen too much now. Zanzibar. Cinnamon and cloves. Luxury resources. Can I earn any other way in the game? Ah! Provide 6 amenities each. Oh, Zanzibar. And because I'm sending the envoys for the first time, it should double, I think. Boom! Money, money, money. Send another envoy to Zanzibar. I won't get double this time, but that's fine. It'll get me up to level 3 with Zanzibar. Where is Zanzibar? They're way up here, aren't they? They are. They're way up north. Yeah. You're probably wrecked. Sorry. Sorry, horseman. Didn't mean to throw you in such a bad position. Once I defeat this guy, I will send my archer up to help them out, though. Because clearly they need it. Two cities... Oh, nice! They finally finished the campus over there. That took a while. Long while. I'm not sure. I might build an industrial zone next to it instead of a holy site like I was planning. Because if it gets the adjacency bonus, I'll totally throw the industrial site there. It'll make it a really good powerhouse for industry. Even though I'm winning... Or winning. I'm doing really well... You silly goose. What are you doing? Oh, shit. You might actually kill him. Oh, no, he didn't. And because of that, we healed up. Thanks, foo. Oh, son of a gun. Ouch. I'm honestly surprised they attacked them. Alright. You get an upgrade. Increased combat strength versus anti-cavalry, yes. Because I'm pretty sure swordsmen are anti-cavalry. Choose production. So that was finally completed. Library would be nice. Only takes 9 turns. But let me check something first. Holy site. So we get plus 3 here if I use the holy site. What about industrial? Would be plus 2 only. So we will build the holy site, but first I'm going to build a library to increase my science. Well, science! Alright, how am I doing here? That's a problem. I'm going to deal with it though as I can. 13 more turns till that's done. Have you been putting cuts into videos? No, sadly. So it's going to be one long-ass video. Tryon, I can and I can't. The only way for me to cut up the video is essentially to... Well, there's a couple ways. For one, I could have hit local record in the beginning, which would have been smart, but I didn't do that. My bad. That way I could have cut it up easily, no problem by myself, and then uploaded it fine. Since it's already been just going and I haven't been recording it locally, the only way for me to cut it up would basically to use a third-party program to download it from YouTube, the video, and then cut it up into pieces, then re-upload them. And that could lead to a significant quality drop. I will try it. But I don't know if it's going to work. After this stream, though, any continuation of this, I will probably make in much smaller chunks. So the first one might be a huge-ass long video. But yeah. Hopefully I can reduce that. This is going to hurt. This is going to hurt a lot. And I can't afford to lose these units. I cannot. So they're retreating immediately after this is over. Yeah, I was afraid that would happen.
There is nothing but a plank.
Ow! Between-